Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I wanted to hop on here really quickly and just do a quick little intro just like in my last Get Ready With Me so we're not just popping up first thing in the morning like with no makeup on this video. Today I am doing another Get Ready With Me. This one is kind of different but kind of the same in the sense of the last one. Basically, I got sunburned on my face on Monday and I've been wearing like no makeup all week. My face has been red, now it's kind of tan and dry and starting to flake, but today I really wanted to wear some makeup but not like my full face of, you know, bronzer and highlighter and like the full shebang. I still wanted to wear a little something something, which is what I came up with here today. It's really simple, it's literally like one eyeshadow. I just kind of thought it would be fun to do so you guys can see like how my makeup goes on with the dry skin and how it applies and everything like that. This is just kind of a more up close look of the makeup that we did for today. Just really neutral cheeks, kind of a really pretty glossy watermelon lip. We did one shade on the eyes with some bronze liner. I hope you all enjoy. Stay tuned because in a few seconds I'm gonna pop up with no makeup on and we're gonna get started on this face. Good morning guys, it's another day of getting ready. Today's is gonna be really interesting because it's not going to be very educational because I'm even winging it for myself and I'm all about like full face and things like that, but here lately, especially this summer because it's been like 100 degrees outside and severe humidity, sometimes putting on all that makeup just isn't worth it. You just don't feel comfortable. I mean, sometimes I will if I'm just going like out like in the evenings or something, but here lately for the past 4 or 5 days, I've been wearing just concealer, mascara, and some days eyeliner and lip gloss, and that's literally been it. Normally I'll wear that on the weekends, but I've been wearing that to work. I've been really comfortable in my skin lately. It's been super duper clear and I'm just in a really happy place right now with my skin. But like I said, it's been like 4 or 5 days since I've worn some foundation and I'm kind of starting to miss it a little bit. But on Monday, I was on the beach for like 5 to 6 hours without sunscreen, and my body was just fine, but my face did burn. So I went through the stage of feeling dry. I went through the stage of hurting. Today, all that's really left, like my forehead's nice tan and so does my nose. I just kind of have like some pink left in my cheeks, but not much because I already naturally have like some pink in my cheeks. Today is the peeling stage and I've been like scratching at some of it and like wiping some of it off and everything because it looked horrible this morning. It looked like dried up toothpaste all around my mouth, so flaky and nasty. My cheeks aren't as bad. My nose just feels like one big crisp, and so liquid makeup is gonna cling to that and look so nasty, so that's why I've been wearing just concealer under my eyes and everything. I'm just worried about like the dry patches. I don't want it clinging and peeling throughout the day and looking nasty, so I'm gonna use a very light layer and amount of foundation today, and I'm not gonna use a foundation that's aimed towards more oily skin either because I don't think that would be a very good combo together. I've already heavily moisturized and used my Mario Badescu facial spray. I've been obsessed with this stuff lately, and like the day I got burned and the day after, this stuff felt extra amazing because it has like the aloe and it's rose water, and next time I go to Ulta I have to buy a new one because I'm getting very low. This is really tragic, but I did already use that as well. But what I'm going to be using today for foundation is my sister's foundation, and she doesn't wear liquid foundation every day, but I know that this isn't super heavy coverage, which I don't want heavy coverage today. Like I said, my skin's really clear. This is my sister's foundation and I think I've only worn it like once, and like literally it matches my body for once, and my sister is always darker than me. She's always like the brown tan and I'm always like the gold tan, but this legit is like matching my body. This Urban Decay foundation is in the shade 4. I'm so nervous. Beautiful foundation, and it works really well for certain skin types, but why is it so watery? I think something is wrong with this foundation, or it's like going bad. Something. Good grief. I use this, and instead of like putting the dots on my face, I'm just going straight onto the back of my hand. Let's start getting ready, fam. I really hope this foundation mixed with the water on this sponge isn't a hot mess, but I'm literally doing just a light layer. It's not gonna be full face like the last Get Ready With Me. It's just like all over my hand. I know this is a more liquidy foundation, but like did my sister's like overheat or something? Like what did she do to this? I just couldn't make myself use color shade. That literally would have been a gross mess, but I knew this foundation was thinner and everything like that, so we're gonna call this like Get Ready With Me
low-key sunburnt edition.
Alright, the foundation is on. I love the coverage of this foundation, but the shade looks really good. Like, it works so well. So well. Like, holy cow, this shade is perfect for my body. Moving on, I've been mixing 10 and 20 of the Fit Me concealer lately, but I don't know what I'm saying. Normally I wear a lot of concealer, but less is more these days. I say less is more as I sit here with liquid foundation all over this dry, sunburnt face. Like I said, don't know what I'm doing. I just had to wear some makeup today, guys, but I'm gonna blend this concealer out just under my eye. I've been putting it on blemishes, but seeing how I'm wearing foundation today, I don't have to worry about that. So I'm just gonna blend this concealer out. I mean, if worst comes to worst, I work at a spa where all of my skincare products are sold, so I can just always go to the back bar and just wash my face if worst comes to worst. Looks good. I used mainly shade 20 with a little bit of shade 10. Looks really good together. I don't know if to use, like, what I've been doing this week. If I wear, like, no makeup, makeup tomorrow, I'll film it. But what I've been doing when I've just been wearing concealer is setting it with that Neutrogena powder. But I don't know if I should set it with Airspun or if I should set it with that. Ooh. I'm going to set it with Airspun just because it's translucent. I don't want this affecting the color. So I'm going to set it with Airspun, but I'm not going to bake. That would be a hot mess. I'm just going to use a little setting brush. I'll probably wear, like, no eyeshadow again today, and it's been terrible. I've been so excited for summertime and to, like, play around with. But honestly, like, this summer, I've just been so slacking with eyeshadow lately. And I just think today's the last day I should be trying to do eyeshadow after the week of makeup I've had. Thinking maybe I should just call this Get Ready With Me, like, I don't know what I'm doing with my life, because I'm literally just like, okay, now what should I do? This is the most awkward makeup experience of my life. I'm just using Brulee from Wet n Wild, like my favorite drugstore eyeshadow. And I'm just putting this from the crease to the brow bone just to lighten that area. I'm not going to worry about sticking it on the lid because this isn't like a eyeshadow look or anything. This is just kind of brightening that area and setting it, because like I used the powder on my eyelid, but I wanted to have like at least some dimensions. And I think I'm going to stick a warm color in the crease and call it a day, just so I can have some depth. I've been using the Milani Bella Cappuccino. I've been using this certain one from Wet n Wild, but today I'm just going to grab something from this Morphe palette. Morphe 350, the Heaven Scent palette. I have not used this in forever. I literally still like have to play around with it. Let's see, what color do I want to use? I'm taking the original Morphe 350 today, and I'm just going to grab this one here. Just gonna stick that right there in the crease. Ever so lightly. What are you doing, Coop? You're literally like messing up all the sheets on my bed.
Get it out. Be back in a little bit.
All right, Daddy, I love you.
I love you, too.
Fun surfing.
Yeah, I tried.
That's good. I just kept, like, layering it up till you could at least see that I was wearing an eyeshadow, and I think that's perfect. That's literally all I need. You can tell there's something there without, like, there being, like, legit nothing. Under my eye, but my under eye area is so dry right now, that would literally make this a mess. I'm gonna stick Brulee lightly with my finger right here just to clean that up. Professional is this. I don't know if I should wear bronzer or if I should wear blush, but I'm definitely not going to do both because there's so much dryness in my cheeks. The last thing I need is like powder products sitting there. So while I think about that, I am going to add some eyeliner. I have been obsessed with this eyeliner ever since I got it. If you guys saw my most recent ColourPop haul, then you have already seen this. It's the Overboard liner. I love this color so much. It's just like, I'll swatch it for you. It's a beautiful bronzy brown shade. I love it so much. I'm just gonna apply this only to the outer half of my upper lash line. And sometimes if it gets a little wonky, I'll take like Wood Winked, or I'll take like Mulch or Tempting or one of those like MAC shades, and I'll go over it and like fix it. But sometimes I can put my eyeliner on straight. I kind of suck at pencil liner, fun fact. Go ahead and do eyebrows. I'm still using that L'Oreal Brow Stylist Definer, one of the best drugstore brow pencils. It's so good. I'm gonna do my brows off camera to save time. And actually, the past couple of days, when I've just been wearing like concealer and mascara, I haven't even been doing my eyebrows, but today the eyebrows are gonna get did. So I did a little bit of brow action, and I was thinking, like, what should I do for my cheeks? Clearly, if you look at me, you know I'm wearing makeup, but I don't want it to be like she's hardcore wearing makeup. So I want to go with a more natural color instead of like pink or coral or something bright or shimmery. I think I'm gonna stick to my amaretto from the Jaclyn Hill Becca Champagne Collection face palette. I have a whole video on this beautiful masterpiece. Amaretto is like my favorite blush ever. It's the middle shade here. I'm just gonna lightly use that blush. I use this mirror for some reason whenever I put like blush and stuff on. I don't know. I don't even want this super noticeable. I just want there to be something there. SOS. SOS. I don't know. It's fine. Everything's fine. I'm fine. It's great. Comment in the comment section below something fun that you guys have done this summer. Like somewhere maybe you've gone on vacation, or something fun you've done with your friends or with your family. I feel like even though this is a chit chat, get ready with me, still all I talk about is makeup. So weird wearing blush and like no bronzer. It's just like, where are your cheekbones? Cause it's just like sloppy. There's just like blush. There's just like no cutoff line. Like, this is so bizarre. YOLO. That's right, YOLO. I mean, there's no turning back at this point. Like, you might as well just go for it. I'm gonna take like the tiniest bit of champagne pop that I've ever used in my entire life, because normally this brush is like drenched. I'm just taking like the tiniest bit. If it even is noticeable, I don't even know, but I just want the tiniest bit. Just the tiniest bit. Okay, I'm kind of going overboard. Okay. Tiniest bit, and I'm not taking it towards the apples and on the apples like I normally do. Just keeping it back there. Go ahead and do lashes so we can be done. I feel like I need an inner corner highlight or a brow bone highlight, something to make my face not look so flat. Oh, I just don't know if I should highlight my inner corner or not. I need something. Maybe I'll do the brow bone instead. Revlon Lash Curler, Waterproof Colossal. It's match made in heaven. Alright, so I have just done my upper and lower lashes, and now this is basically it for the makeup. I really like it. Like, if I weren't so dry and everything, I might would have to try this look on an average day, like no bronzer and no heavy eyeshadow and things, because this is kind of the makeup that I've been into lately. It's just super easy and it looks really effortless. I really like it. It's not as tragic as I thought it was gonna be, and I don't know, it's just so weird seeing myself with this much makeup on. I'm gonna go like get dressed for work and all that kind of stuff, and then I will come back in a little bit to wrap up the video. I'll have my lip on and we will just finish on up. Alright guys, I am back to finish off this video. This is just basically how the makeup turned out in the end. I just wanted to give you guys kind of like an up close little look. Basically, what I did lip-wise for today's makeup, I definitely didn't want anything matte because my face is pretty matte and it would just bring more attraction to the dry patches and things like that. So I wanted something more glossy. So I lined my lips with the Jessie's Girl. This is such a throwback brand from Rite Aid. Like, who remembers it? Jessie's Girl Naked Lip Liner. This is such an oldie but a goodie to me. I love this color. It's kind of like a My Lips But Better reddish berry kind of shade. And then this is super interesting. I've had this sample from It Cosmetics all summer long, literally sitting in my makeup collection, and I had never opened it, I had never used it. I don't know why all of a sudden today I decided to check it out, but it is the It Cosmetics Ultra Hydrating CC Lip Serum, Why I never tried this, I don't know, but today I put it on. It matches with this lip liner really well, and it is beautiful. Camera's making it look a lot more pink, but in person it is just like a beautiful berry, rose, like mauve-y kind of color. It's kind of like watermelon, like a watermelon undertone, but it is so pretty, like smooth and creamy on the lips, not tacky at all. It smells like vanilla, and this is a really nice size sample. Like, can we talk about the size of it? I regret not trying this little guy sooner, but now that I've tried it, I will definitely keep on using it. This one is in the shade Love. It says hydrating, anti-aging, color correcting cream gloss with clinically proven collagen peptides, hyaluronic acid, plus 9 essential butters and oils. Does that not sound amazing? Anyways, that's today's makeup. Get ready with me for today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It was so fun and crazy, like putting makeup on with like a sunburn that's healing and like dry skin. That foundation, by the way, is amazing. I'm loving it so far. I've only had it on for like an hour or two, but it feels so good. I mean, I didn't even set it with powder or anything, and I always set my foundations with powder. Other than that, thanks so much for watching today's Get Ready With Me. I'll be back for more soon. That'll be more exciting. Maybe we'll play around with some fun colors on the eyes or things like that. And I still have to show you guys how I do my fake freckles. Hey guys, that's it. I hope you all are having an amazing summer and an amazing day, and I will talk to you all very soon. Bye you guys. Mwah.